did I get here? And where is here? Wait, there's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there. So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I'm okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There. Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson?
There you go, Victoria.
I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Because of her images of hopeless faces.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right?
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century.
Seriously,
but
though,
I like it old
school.
I could
frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of
desperation. I do love my analog camera.
And any one of you could.
I should take a quick picture now.
Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to... Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely
popular. Sorry, Max. No more selfies right now.
The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing ass. Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool.
Everybody in class is turning in a photo, so you see the dilemma?
I know, Mr. Jeff.
Now I wish I wouldn't have read this. Purge. Hi, Kate.
Oh. Hi, Max.
I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much.
Just by participating. By putting yourself out there in the world. No matter who wins, this is just a bump.
I hear that. I don't want anybody to go grab a cup of tea and bitch about life?
Thanks, but not today. I have to go over homework.
No worries. Let's hang later.
Sure.
I only want to share whatever gifts I have with the world.
Huh. This might make a cool shot. Of course, Victoria has to have the bestest, newest, most expensive everything. Even her school books are gift-wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? And people laughed. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell. Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me. You can never escape the lighthouse here. Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait to watch some more documentaries on this bad boy. Here's the poster for the contest. Mr. Jefferson really expects me to enter. Why? I don't know if I'm ready for my 15 minutes of infamy.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I'm not paying $100.
You always
welcome to the real world.
Cute.
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture in charity class. They're just getting you ready.
Because Max wants everybody to see how big she is.
What's the point?
She plays it so sharp.
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
Thank you.
think that's Courtney. She's such a slave to Taylor and Victoria. There's Taylor, always waiting for Victoria. Imagine a world. Ah, the science room. Here's the portal to Warren's American brain. Girls, I'd like these missing persons posters are popping up everywhere. You. I shouldn't be so stingy with my blood. By the seaside, watching the world from the Evan doesn't say much to me, but his photos are very cool. Alyssa is always texting, but she doesn't hang out with a lot of people. Having everybody see inside my locker. I love that picture of Mom and Dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you look totally fabulous, as usual. Yes, this poster must stop bullies dead in their tracks. That's Dana talking to, I think his name is Justin. I wish I had. Dana is on my floor, too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader. They must make them in a factory. I shouldn't be so catty. Dana is nice to me. I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type. I hate bully jockstraps like Logan. Auntie's a Vortex Club member. Poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan. It looks like she's been gone for months. I cry sometimes, walking around. Don't need a PC, missed the poetry jam tryouts, and I did not steal that backpack. Why she cries sometimes, talking. That's so messed up. I should contact them to find out what I can do. As if I am. Good thing I left my AK at home. No one could dry her fountain. They should just call it a sugar machine. That would be awesome if you put money in there and a bag of sugar dropped out. That's when I fly. The principal doesn't come out of his office much. Rachel Amber. She's so pretty. I hate these posters. So sad. Miss Grant is a great science teacher. How many students ever actually memorize all this shit? I guess we all should these days. He's cute. I like skater boys. Too bad they don't like me. The Bigfoot stomp. I should develop some school spirit. Goatee. Yay, Halloween. My favorite time of year. There's Juliet from my dorm. Yet another Vortex Club disciple. Figures Juliet would be dating Zachary. Jocks sucked up in the Vortex Club. God, Samuel is such a weirdo. But I kinda like that about him. Nerd alert. This poster has Warren written all over it. To all of you, American girls, it's sad to. Empty. Good. Nobody can see my meltdown, except for me. Now, who would bother to write that crap? I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy? The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you. I'm good to flow, thanks. This poster must drive people to have sex. I remember when somebody punked the alarm last month. At least I got out of science class for that quiz. Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day. Whoa, where did that butterfly come from? It doesn't look like any kind I've ever seen before. The blue wings are practically glowing. I can almost feel the air moving around me. The butterfly feels almost like a spirit.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho! No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us in.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit.
Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Capture the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy,
anybody?
I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why are.
I did it.
Can you give
I
me
actually
an example
did
of a
it.
Photographer who perfectly captured
I'm a human
the human condition
time
in
machine.
Black and white? Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
What is going on? Keep it together, Max.
You feel
still
like
the
totally
same stupid picture. When I took my selfie, my
she
pencil case is still
tortured,
in the same
right?
place.
And frankly, it's bullshit. Shh, 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 shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though. I could frame any one of you in a dark.
Shh, shh, shh.
I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not
of
dreaming
course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation.
So
was
I can
the
go
first
back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
Can
remains
I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I'm sorry. I feel sick. May I be excused?
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me
he
after class.
Was a French painter
and I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
Tail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American to carry a...
I must have missed something. I should rewind. Think, Max. Rewind and find something.
Bro, Max!
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. But you can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of Evan. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Yes, Victoria, you still have to...
Nice answer, Max. Are you okay? You look pale.
Kate, did we talk at all today?
This is the first time. What's wrong?
I'm sorry, I'm just dripping. Too much stress.
I know the feeling.
I
just really think Everyday Heroes
is an important cultural event. I wish we didn't. I do have to go, but we can talk later if you want.
I'll see how I feel. Thanks, Max.
No matter who wins, this is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want anybody to feel excluded from this
process. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
I had my moment.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars of...
I'm not avoiding, just...
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. I had my moment in the camera.
Excuse me.
Never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy. Brooke has no idea of the shit going on right now.
Daniel, you remember that it's payday?
You know I don't tease.
I hate that.
No, Max, they can't save that girl in the bathroom. Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing?
Don't
come on, put that thing down!
I need a hammer to break it open!
I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they? No way!
Don't ever tell touch me again, freak!
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm since that's your job. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
class.
Just
tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
No, he does not buy that at all. I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet. Yes, I could rewind and actually tell him the truth. Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her. Posters over posters? I would so be there if a Sasquatch actually did battle a Razorback. Hey, Hayden.
There she is, the retro selfie master.
That's me, all right. You look relaxed as usual, Hayden.
It's a skill one cultivates at Blackwell, especially when one represents the Vortex Club. Not to boast.
What the hell is the Vortex Club anyway? It seems so elitist.
Only if you're not cool enough to get in, and it doesn't hurt your resume.
If you say so.
I do. But you should actually come hang with us one night, then you wouldn't be so inclined to gossip.
You mean hang with a Vortex Club? That sounds like a setup to a horrible prank.
Chillax, paranoia girl. We're not that desperate for fun. We know how to do that on our own.
It seems weird to think about partying with all those Rachel Amber posters up.
You're high. Rachel used to hang out with us too. She was a blast. Smart, not bitchy like, you know.
So you knew Rachel Amber?
I knew she liked to party. Fun to be around. Oh, yeah, and she was hot.
Rachel was actually a member of the Vortex Club?
No. Rachel was like her own club. She was actually too cool for us. And I'll deny I ever said that.
What do you think happened to her?
Whatever happens to people who disappear without a trace?
Did Victoria like Rachel? She seems like the jealous type.
Don't think you know Victoria so well. She respected Rachel, even if she didn't act like it.
Do you really want Nathan Prescott to represent?
Oh, please. Nathan is like everybody's voodoo doll. Kill the rich kid. He's all right and a fun guy to hang with. Fuck the haters.
He seems genuinely unstable to me.
Nate has his extreme moments, but don't we all?
I don't know yet, Hayden. Let's talk later, Hayden.
Bye, Max. No, I have to get my chemical on and study. We should get you and Dana out one night.
Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
Is that really yours? Is that even legal?
Of course. Nobody knows about it yet.
Isn't it considered a weapon of war?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny, Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
What a complicated name for such a tiny drone. Hi, Brooke.
Let me get.
That looks like a high-fly drone. Model B400 EVO. Now, that's a nice piece of tech.
You're full of surprises. Why would you know that?
I love aerial photography. Drones are perfect for that, especially those with great range. It's a new era of images.
Most impressive, Max. Warren said you were multifaceted. Here, give the drone a whirl around campus.
I better read Warren. Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive. Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition, but would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Mattson, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus. Halls, classrooms, gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
I guess cameras could have helped Rachel. I can see both sides.
You're fair-minded, Max. And we all pray Rachel is found safe and sound, bless her soul. But this petition isn't about her. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage, from the Native Americans who founded this land to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
The Native Americans?
The tribes who were here first, who welcomed the settlers. Both cultures found a mutual symbiosis and thrived. Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Absolutely. I don't mind security, but not pure surveillance.
I knew you were my favorite new student at Blackwell for a good reason.
Hey there, Stella.
Hey, I know you. You're the new quiet girl in Jefferson's class. Isn't he incredible?
He's aloof. He seems like he's always above you. Not like a snob, but like you don't know what's in his head.
Maybe. Mr. Jefferson just has his own style. If Victoria wasn't all over him, I would definitely make a move.
Victoria is pretty obvious. I don't think Jefferson is into her.
I don't think she's closed the deal, but she's not the only player.
Now, how do you know this?
You have a lot to learn here at Blackwell. Rachel Amber absolutely had sex with him. Well, I heard that from a good source.
So, you knew Rachel?
Not really. I saw her hanging with the other cool kids like Victoria. Not my kind of clique. But I heard insane stories about Rachel.
That's so cool that Blackwell is doing a show of Mr. Jefferson's work. Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous falling soldier?
Isn't it Robert Dornau?
Oh my. You can't even tell the difference between street photography and photojournalism. No portfolio peek for you.
Hey, Evan.
Let's see if you're...
Robert Capa, of course. I love his work, despite the controversy about that photo.
My, my. This quiet child knows things.
That's why I'm here.
You're a kindred spirit, Max. Would you care for a perusal of my portfolio? It's not a privilege I grant to many.
I'd be honored, sir. These photos are great. And Rachel Amber's face is mesmerizing. Hi, Evan.
As you can see, Rachel Amber was my favorite model here. She knew exactly what angles worked best with my eye.
You were close.
Like brother and sister in arms. She understood me, never judged me. I hated her Vortex Club clique, but she never acted like she cared. Her friends were her friends.
What do you think happened to her?
Nothing good, Max. Nothing good.
Clever. Hello?
Max, I don't feel like talking.
What's wrong?
Nathan Prescott, little rich bitch kid. He thinks he can own people like his parents own Blackwell. Like he owns the Vortex Club.
Yes, he's a nasty piece of work.
Somebody needs to take that prick down.
He'll take himself down.
Yeah, history always proves that, right? Just wait for justice, you sheeple.
What's up, Daniel?
Oh, hi, Max. Could I, ask you a question? Would you mind letting me sketch you? I do put my sketches on Facebook, though.
I'd be honored, Daniel. Makes me feel like a muse.
Funny you should say that. I was just thinking about my real muse. Rachel Amber.
You knew her?
No, but once she asked me to draw her portrait, oh, she was a natural.
hard to avoid her posters all over campus.
Kills me to see her sweet face used as a crime photo. She had a good heart.
So what happened to her? There's gotta be a story.
She just stopped coming to class. Some people said she ran away. Some say she jumped off a cliff. I just hope she's okay.
Okay. Why don't you start drawing me? Even though I must be a step down from Rachel.
No way! You're a good substitute, Muse. Oh, that's a good posture. Good. Good.
Best portrait ever. This day has been so insane. Everything is happening too fast. And none of it makes any sense. These visions, this power. I keep expecting to wake up one more time. But if this is a dream, then I'm not asleep. Which means somehow I did rewind time. So there has to be a reason. And I have to find out why. Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max. Come to thrash?
Oh yeah? Bring it.
What's your first move gonna be?
Jump?
You're such a poser. If you can't even name a simple nose slide or a tray flip, you should walk on.
Yo, just...
check out the...
I came to nose slide. But I'd love to see somebody do a tray flip.
Oh, sick. You're not a poser.
Nah, I just can't skate worth shit.
Aw, check it. We're gonna destroy some rails for you. What do you want to see?
Go for a tree flip.
Let's get Trevor all over that action. Oh, ow. Oh. Ooh. I'm stoked to see those photos framed and shit. You never really escaped Betty, though.
I used to be, but I'm into my camera now.
I can tell. We need more girls out here. Rachel Amber and her punk friend used to skate with us.
You knew Rachel?
She used to chill with us sometimes. One day, she just vanished. I hope she's living the dream somewhere. If anybody hurt her, we'll get a skate posse and take them out with our boards.
Who was Rachel's punk friend?
I can't remember her name. She was hot. Tats, blue hair, hardcore. She stopped hanging out with us after Rachel disappeared. Ran away.
You ever hang out with Victoria?
Fuck that. I'd rather rollerblade than hang out with snobs like her.
Let's chill later, Justin.
Anytime you want to take some action shots, we're here for you, Max.
This is a great image. All those rippling green coins. I hope everybody got their wish.
I bet the Blackwell founders would shit cats if they saw today's student body walking around like zombies on their phones.
Bring it, Brock. Yeah!
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive. The Prescott dormitory? Good Lord, Nathan's family owns my dorm?
Oh. Hi, Max.
How are you doing?
Fantastic. I'm by myself reading Chicklet. Pretty soon I'll be bonding with Victoria at the Vortex Club.
I think you're better off reading Chicklet.
Good point. Now if you'll excuse me.
Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly.
Sweet. Nice.
Hi, Kate.
Hey, Max.
You look down. You okay?
I'm kind of over humanity today. Sorry to be a drama queen.
Is there anything...
Max, I'd like to be alone, if you don't mind. I'm sorry.
Howdy, Samuel.
Well, hello there.
You look busy, Samuel.
I'm always up to something. Today it's sweeping. Then painting windows.
Just don't paint over the posters for Rachel Amber.
You can't color over that sunlight.
You knew Rachel?
How can you know a prism? You just stare in awe. Now I have to go paint windows.
What do you think happened to her?
Best not to dwell on the past. Samuel looks forward. Nice. Like a clock.
What was she like? She must have been popular.
Even sunlight can cast shadows. Rachel did both at once, you know.
Awesome.
She was like a battery. Positive and negative.
See you later, Samuel.
And watch your step around here, Max. After I sweep, I paint.
Don't take it out on the tree, loser.
No.
Oh, look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit.
No.
The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose.
Oh,
so original.
Dude.
Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
Sweet.
I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps. Do you understand English?
Yeah.
Get lost.
Yeah. I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way. I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it.
No. Keep walking, hippie.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Samuel is sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
No.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max. I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me.
Dude.
You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
No!
Victoria probably played me. I should have played her. Is this a Vortex Club or a Victoria Club initiation? Truly pathetic.
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
Room 217? No way in hell am I ever going in here.
Dana's still a cheerleader at heart.
Could be fun. Glad I'm not the only lonely nerd around here.
Thanks for the warning.
How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say. Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break. Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon. It's hard to believe I'm 18 now. I'm lucky my parents enabled my photo habit into adulthood. It's not exactly pretty and pink, but no shits are given. I like my wardrobe. Would Man Ray call them selfie portraits? I'm glad Kate let me borrow her copy of The October Country. I should have every Bradbury book for myself. I'll miss going to the games with my dad. Go Thunderbirds. I haven't forgotten you, little Lisa. Yet. You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up. One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time. That's the only tourist picture I let them take of me at the Space Needle. That was a good hockey game and a great fight. Man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the Fremont Troll. I should hit the thrift store and pick up some dollar vinyl. Cartier-Bresson, Doineau, Hamilton, the great. So cheesy, but it makes me smile thinking of the day Mom and I sewed that together. Ahoy, Captain. At least I know you've got my back. When I swallowed your eye and my parents rushed me to the ER, I knew we were bonded forever. The Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall. I love that Mom sent me a fat box of chocolate coconut bites for my birthday and slipped in a $200 gift certificate. She sure knows how to make a sad birthday happy.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
Let me out, Juliet. This is so stupid.
Looks like nobody won this TP war. There's nothing left but ghosts. Hey, Juliet.
You are ridiculous.
Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk, just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything, but I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
Dior, Givenchy, you could pay for my tuition with that wardrobe. Those boots are made for walking runways. That is a tasty plasma. Maybe I could sneak in and watch Final Fantasy Spirits Within. I don't care what anybody says, that's one of the best sci-fi films ever made. I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this article. Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much? How insecure. I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here. Yes, I get it. Enter the Vortex Club. No. Okay, if I did wear expensive jewelry, I would wear this for sure. They should call this series aloof. Cold and soulless. Kinda like Victoria. Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse. Ouch. Well, at least she puts her photographs out there. Unlike me. She's actually got a classic medium format camera with some awesome prime lens. I hate you, Victoria. Whoa, I had no idea Victoria's parents owned the Chase space. Color me impressed. I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this article. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent. Those boots are made for walking runways. Speaking of selfies... Let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here. And this one there. A pattern is emerging.
Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren. I can't even imagine what life would be like being a cheerleader. Dramatic, I guess. It would be a cool sticker without the words. This is both sad and pathetic. Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. It's so fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world. And yes, Max, so terribly wrong. That looks like a home pregnancy test.
Max, that's mine. Thank you. You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Nice, Max. You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again. But I could rewind and make it up to her. Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Dana, I'm not trying to be nosy, but I heard a rumor about you.
What? Who told you I was pregnant?
Nobody important. They just acted like it was bullshit. I just wanted you to know.
It's like a goddamn reality show around here. Can you keep a secret, Max?
Of course.
I was pregnant. Was.
Oh. What about the other?
Deadbeat Dad? You can catch him on the 40-yard line this Friday. And it's not Zachary.
Sorry to pry. It's not my business. And I won't be at the game Friday. Not much school spirit, I guess.
I like your spirit, Max. Anyway, you better get that flash drive so Warren has an excuse to bug you.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Now I feel too wiped out to leave.
Good lord. Dana really was on her own. I better make sure everything is still in there. I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder. Not that I would open it no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect. Warren even left me a little message with his flash drive. He's such a goofball. I haven't forgotten you, little Lisa. Yet.
This shit.
Ow! That hurt!
Damn, I better rewind. Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Bullies never change.
That's why you're better off.
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should... I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied. Good thing I don't have a car. Yet. The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster. Damn, somebody is seriously devoted to putting up these posters. It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes clean me on it. I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay lots. The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster.
Max, get your ass over here!
I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
I don't get it. How could Zach and Victoria do that to me?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Come on over here, please. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash.
Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Not at all. Sensitive is good, unless you're a pushover. You have hip taste and a quick mind.
Thanks for noticing, Max.
The right girl will too.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren.
Oh! No, I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt, and you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah, must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I wanted to. I was just so tripped out over leaving Arcadia.
Oh, please. I'm sure your phone and laptop were frozen in time.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max. Haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Old cardboard boxes. So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. I think this junk swallowed her discs. She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now? Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Damn. Chloe was kicked out of Blackwell 2 years ago. She used to be a great student. When she cared.
I guess you love awkward silence instead of music?
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble. I'm not into them. Too pretentious. Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia. Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
This postcard is from Rachel Ember. Anything. I wonder if Chloe is taking those pills. I hope she's okay. I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products. You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am. This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today. Act, React, or Die, a 21st Century Survival Guide. Whoop. Dog tags. Sweet. David Mattson.
Joyce always loved her mail order catalogs of Aww. Joyce has a little shrine to William. Her new husband may not be such a douche. These books have not been touched since the last decade. I see why.
I'm singing songs about the future.
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Joyce still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon. Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking. I can feel autumn pushing out the summer. William used to grill awesome burgers for us. I wonder if he was the last one to use this. What do you truly want to do when you grow up?
Max, I'm already grown up. What about you?
Travel. That would be awesome. Explore the world, go far from here.
Far from me? Thanks a lot, dude.
Dude, you would totally come with me. I need a bodyguard for our adventures.
I would be like Lara Croft, except real. That would be majorly cool.
Totally. We'd have cars and boats and planes all over for instant escape. And no adults could tell us what to do.
Count me in. What would you do while I was bodyguarding you?
Maybe take pictures of our adventures. I would love to be a photographer. As if I ever could be.
What are you talking about? Max, you are a photographer. Your pictures could be in a museum. Someday they will. I believe in you.
That took Chloe and me the whole day to draw. It's almost invisible now. Hey, I remember that stain. Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted. If I took this picture, the deer would be standing on your ass.
Come on, open it, chicken.
Hold on, and I'm not chicken.
Prove it. You drink first, Max.
No way. It was your idea, Chloe.
Whatever. Give me that bottle.
Well?
Tasty. Very tasty.
Here, I want a sip.
Sorry, this is not for kids.
Don't be greedy. Give me some.
Oh shit, the carpet!
There's wine all over. What do we do now?
My parents are coming. Cover it up.
I guess they're aging, these books. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me.
One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat.
Yes! Score!
These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
Shit! Butterfingers!
Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird. Poor little dear. It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead. Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Yes! You have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
I wanted to. What if he goes on some rampage?
Nathan fronts like a thug, but he's a spoiled punk-ass biatch.
He would have shot you, Chloe. That's a fact.
I should tell the principal.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
Seriously, I didn't blab to anybody. Promise.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me. Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck. Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin'. Paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth, that's an order. Whose is it?
I'm sorry. That was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home. Especially dopers. So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy. I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang!
Jesus, put that thing down!
Chillax, sister. It's not even loaded.
yet.
I thought you believed in gun control.
Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody. Even Chloe.
You're giving me a look I haven't seen for a while. What's the problem?
Why steal a gun from your stepdad? You know you're gonna get busted.
Or somebody like Nathan will bust me with a cap. Screw that. I need to cover my own back.
Your stepdad won't let you off the hook that easy.
What the hell does he need another gun for? To mow down Bigfoot cheerleaders?
This is all just so scary.
I know, Max. But I do feel safer having a 9mm in my pants.
Can you actually use it?
After about 100 online videos? Hell yeah.
Just don't keep it in your pants, okay?
Max, I'm not looking for trouble. I just want protection. If anybody in this country should have guns, it should be women. Awesome sauce? Totally reminds me of when we were kids. Come on, slowpoke!
Hold on. I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today. Birds are so lucky, they can always escape. Oh my god, I forgot all about this. Too bad I can't rewind that far back. How long has that been here? Clearly, the Bigfoots are everywhere. Sure you don't want to be alone?
Have a seat, Pete.
You're in a good mood.
Seeing my step dork get played makes me happy.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
Well, yeah, I couldn't help it.
Never change. What did you find?
Creepy photos of Kate Marsh, other Blackwell students.
This dude takes his job too seriously. He still thinks he's at war or something. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
So, what about you and Nathan?
We went to his room at Blackwell. We drank, and I laughed at his rich kid bullshit. He was one step ahead and put something in my beer.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Good thing you didn't tell anyone. Nathan Prescott better watch his back now.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Storm like this in Oregon. Oh my lord! The tornado is back! October 11th? Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away!
The tornado is headed straight for the town.
Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. You just zoned.
No, no, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something
Hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had the same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.